All right, so welcome. Today we're going to talk about the metric system. In this comic, we got a joke for the metric system. It says, today we convert to the metric system. And it says, but we're inchworms, because inches are not a part of the metric system. And then this little guy in the front is saying, go back to France, because all the other countries besides the USA use the metric system. So in science, we are going to use the metric system this year. Here's our target. We actually have two targets for this lesson. First, recognize and correctly use the appropriate metric unit and prefixes. And then second, accurately measure length, mass, and volume. So our metric system, a brief overview, is based on our decimal or base 10 system. So when we convert between the metric system, it makes it nice and easy because we're just jumping base 10. Sometimes it's also called the standard international units, or SI. So if it says, what is the SI unit for length, we know that that means what is the metric unit for length. And then everyone in the whole wide world besides the United States of America uses the metric system. We use the empirical system. So if you've ever driven a car, or you're getting your driver's permit, you might notice on the speedometer that it's also on the inside in km/hour. That means kilometers per hour. So they make cars for the rest of the world, and then they put the miles on the outside for us. So as we mentioned before, our metric system has prefix, and all of our stuff is based on the unit 10. So the word prefix means that it's going to come before the word, and it's going to tell us about it. In the metric system, we have these prefixes right here, kilo, hecto, deca, unit. The unit just stands for standard. Deci, centi, and milli, and they're all based on the unit 10. So our unit is our standard, and that just means one. Deca means that it's times 10. Hecto, times 100. Kilo, times 1,000. So 1 kilometer is 1,000 meters. We're going to work with converting metric prefixes in a later lesson. Again, here's our metric prefixes. So our standard base units, and they come before the base units. So this stands for kilometer, kilogram, kiloliter, meters, grams, liters. Our tenth would be deci, decimeter, decigram, deciliter. And you can see as we're moving to the left from one, it's times 10 every time. And as we move to the right of one, it's divide by 10 every time. Here are our metric units. I highly suggest that you memorize this chart right here. What's really important is length, mass, and volume. Time and temperature are pretty much standard for us. So our length is meter, mass is kilograms, temperature is Kelvin, but in science we're going to use degrees Celsius. Our volume for S means solid is going to be a cubic meter. Volume for L, meaning liquid, is going to be a liter. Our time is seconds, and density is grams per liter or grams per meter cubed, because we've got a formula for it, which is mass divided by volume. Here we go. Meters. Meter measures length or distance, so from point A to point B. 1 millimeter is about the thickness of a dime. Centimeter is about the width of a large paperclip or your fingernail. A meter is about the width of a doorway. A kilometer is about 6 city blocks or about 10 football fields. And 1.6 kilometers equals about 1 mile. Next, we're going to take a look at our metric unit for mass, which is a gram. So grams are used to measure mass. Mass is the number of atoms in a substance. A lot of times we get mass and weight confused. So sometimes people say, oh yeah, well, mass is like its weight, but weight depends on gravity where mass doesn't. So your mass would stay the same if you went to the moon, regardless of gravity, but your weight would change. So you're going to weigh much less on the moon than you would on Earth because there's less gravity on the moon. So our mass is just the number of atoms in an object. A milligram weighs about as much as a grain of salt, so not very much at all. A gram is about as much as a small paperclip. A kilogram weighs about as much as 6 apples or 2 pounds. Next, we're going to talk about liters or volume.
So liters measure liquids. They're going to measure volume or capacity. Volume is the amount of space that something takes up. So 1 milliliter is about the drop of, or about the size of 1 drop of liquid. A liter is about half a 2-liter Coke bottle. This is probably something we're more familiar with. We use liters a lot. A kiloliter would be about 5 bottles of soda. We also use meters cubed when we're talking about volume. So we're talking about the amount of space something takes up. So for volume in a regularly shaped object, like this rectangle here or this 3-dimensional cube, we can find the amount of space it takes up by doing length times width times height. So if we start with our cube, the length of the cube is 3, so we would do 3. Length times width, which is also 3, times 3, our height. 3 times 3 times 3 equals 27. And then when we're doing this, we're also taking centimeters times centimeters times centimeters. So we would have centimeters cubed. Same thing over here. Let's pretend all of these are meters. It's a house. 12 meters by 4 meters by 3 meters. That's a short house. So we would take length times width times height. And then our units are going to be meters times meters times meters. For the volume of an irregularly shaped object, so an object that's not like these cubes or rectangles, we're going to do what we call water displacement.
Today we'll show you how to find the volume of an irregular shaped object. The volume of the object is the amount of space that it takes up. The units that are used for volume are cubic centimeters for solids and cubic milliliters for liquids. An irregular shaped object cannot be easily measured. To see what the volume of an irregular shaped object is, we have to use the water displacement method. The water displacement method is used to compare the liquid volume before and after an object is placed into it. To find the volume of 3 small rocks, we will measure the difference in volume in 70 milliliters of colored water. As you could see now, my partner is now filling up the graduated cylinder with 70 milliliters of colored water. Next, we will place the rocks inside the water, then measure the bottom of the meniscus again. As you can see, the water's volume has increased due to the rocks that have been put into it. Now we have to subtract the difference between the beginning volume and the end volume. In this case, the rocks have increased the water to about 73 milliliters. The difference is 3 milliliters. In order to get the volume, you need to convert the units to centimeters. 1 milliliter equals 1 centimeter cubed.
What unit would you use to measure each of the following items? In these problems, we're going to practice measuring length or reading length on a meter stick. In each picture, the large numbers represent exactly 1 centimeter. Each line in between represents 1 millimeter. to mark 13.8 centimeters, we would go to 13, and then we have to go over 8 millimeters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This spot would be 13.8 centimeters. Please mark 8.3 centimeters. Use the pen to mark 15.7 centimeters. Use the pen to mark 12.1 centimeters. For each of the following graduated cylinders, we are going to find the volume. Please read the volume for each graduated cylinder. Notice that each cylinder is recorded in milliliters. In these problems, we are again finding the volume. In this portion of the video practice, you will be finding the volume of an irregularly shaped object through water displacement. Please find the volume of the baby T-Rex. Please find the volume of the fish. Please find the volume of Scuba Steve. In this portion of the practice, you will be finding the volume of a regularly shaped object. Please find the volume of each cube and insert your answer. In this portion of the practice, you will be finding the length of each colored line in centimeters. Each of these rulers is a metric ruler. Please insert your answer for each line in the boxes provided. Please indicate the length of each arrow for each of the metric rulers. Congratulations, you are
very good.
In these practice problems, you are also going to be finding the volume of a liquid. However, these practice problems require decimals. Please pay close attention to how much each interval represents in the pictures. In these problems, you'll find the volume of irregularly shaped objects. You will complete this task by using the water displacement method. Please find the volume of the baby dinosaur. Please find the volume of the fish. Please find the volume of Scuba Steve. In these problems, you're going to practice finding the volume of regularly shaped objects. Remember, the formula for volume is length times width times height. Please find the volume of cube 2. Please find the volume of cube 3. In these practice problems, you're going to be finding the length of each line in centimeters. Please find the length of the pink line. Notice the pink line starts right here. Please find the length of the green line. Please find the length of the blue line. Enter the length of the orange line now. In these practice problems, you'll be determining the point marked on each ruler in centimeters. Please determine the point marked on ruler 1 now. 2, 3, and 4. You have completed your metric system notes. You should now be able to recognize and correctly use appropriate metric unit and prefixes, and accurately measure length, mass, and volume. Thanks for watching!